Hey guys, Kyudai Kino here. So by the time I post this, it'll probably be about 2 weeks or so from the release of Godzilla King of the Monsters. I'm excited about it. I can't stop watching that final trailer that came out a little while ago. The Kaiju Crew Discord's watching the Monarch Sciences website. I've talked to people who aren't even that into kaiju movies who are excited for it. I think it's safe to say that the hype for this movie is in full effect. Considering G-Fest 21 back in 2014 broke attendance records and may have accelerated the rate at which the convention is frankly outgrowing its longtime venue, I think it's safe to expect a lot of new fans to get into the Godzilla series because of this movie. Some people out there who are planning to see this movie are probably looking to see at least a couple of the past movies, just to get familiar with Godzilla's history. James Rolfe already did a great video giving a rundown of the series' history, and some recommendations for places to start. He makes some good recommendations and his rationale for his selections is solid, but I thought I'd take a different approach and give a more comprehensive overview of the entire series, with a brief impression of each film and an appraisal of whether it's a good starting point for newcomers. There are over 30 films at this point, so I'll try to keep my comments on each film short. The original Godzilla from 1954 is essential viewing and a terrific film, but it might not be the ideal introduction if you don't already watch a lot of older movies. I wouldn't discourage anyone from starting with it, though. If you're into film noir, you might also like the American adaptation, Godzilla King of the Monsters, which restructures the film in a noir-style flashback with requisite narration by Raymond Burr as American reporter Steve Martin. Godzilla Raids Again is similar in tone to the first film, and focuses more on kind of a keep calm and carry on wartime story about ordinary people coping with a crisis. If you liked the first film, you might like this one. Although the US version, while it's an entertaining hack job, is probably best saved for already dedicated fans.
This is bad. This is bad.
King Kong vs. Godzilla is immensely entertaining, and probably a great introduction if you don't mind older special effects. The US version plays the premise straighter and is good fun, but if you don't mind going beyond official disc releases, the Japanese version is a sharp comedy that satirizes the emerging corporate culture and mass media, including itself. Mothra vs. Godzilla made James's list, and I'll gladly second his recommendation. It's got a great all-star cast of actors who made other appearances in Toho's special effects films, and Mothra's involvement brings with it an interesting fantasy element. The third act drags just a bit, but the film thoroughly deserves its reputation as one of the series' classics. If you like this one, I also recommend Mothra's debut film, which features some of the Toho crew's best effects work. Ghidorah the Three-Headed Monster is a great introduction as well, adding science fiction and crime thriller elements to the mix, plus some spectacular effects and the same monster cast that's headlining the new King of the Monsters. Also, if you like some shipping material in your movies, Naoko and Princess Selno have got you covered. Monster Zero, also known as Invasion of Astro Monster, features perhaps the most gloriously 60s alien invasion ever committed to film. If you're a big sci-fi fan, especially vintage stuff like Forbidden Planet or This Island Earth, this one's a must. Godzilla vs. the Sea Monster is maybe a bit questionable as a first film, but not bad. It's a fun, colorful island adventure with plenty of human and monster action. If you like 60s James Bond movies, especially Dr. No, you might like this one. Son of Godzilla is good fun as well, but maybe not a great introduction. If you see Sea Monster and like it, though, give this one a watch. Destroy All Monsters has a long-standing reputation as one of the high points of the franchise. The effects and monster scenes absolutely deserve that reputation, but the human story in between really doesn't. It might be a good idea to hold off on this one until you've seen a handful of the other movies. Godzilla's Revenge, or All Monsters Attack, is one of the most hated entries in the series, and while I actually think it's pretty good, more on that in another video one of these days, no doubt, it is so out there that it may turn off newcomers, despite offering a lot of monster action in a short runtime. Godzilla vs. the Smog Monster, or Godzilla vs. Hedorah, is an intensely stylized and psychedelic film and easily one of the series' most unique. If you like films involving intense or heightened visuals, or that deal with 60s and 70s counterculture, this might actually be a pretty good starting point. It's not typical of the series, but I could see it being a good gateway for fans of, say, House. I kinda like Godzilla vs. Gigan, and it does offer plenty of monster action, but it occupies an odd space where it's not as solid a film as many of the 60s entries, but not as wild as, say, Godzilla vs. Megalon. I'm dubious on it as an introduction, but if you've already been introduced, by all means, give it a watch. Godzilla vs. Megalon has a lot of the same problems as Gigan: lower production value, a slapdash script, a lot of recycled footage to save money, but it's got a certain goofy charm that I can't quite put my finger on, which Gigan lacks. It's just so unabashedly absurd. Jet Jaguar might make this one a fun introduction if you're already into tokusatsu superhero shows like Ultraman, Kamen Rider, or Super Sentai. Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla is a mixed bag. It's the first appearance of an iconic monster and has an incredibly fun score by Masaru Sato, but I find the human characters so unmemorable that it's difficult for me to recommend this one as an introduction. Terror of Mechagodzilla was kind of a last gasp for the original series, and while it has some interesting elements, it's to date the only Godzilla film written by a woman, and its tragic human story is a standout among the series' scattered attempts at romance. Nevertheless, I can't quite recommend it to a newcomer. The Return of Godzilla is very moody and atmospheric, with some explicit Cold War elements driving the plot. The Japanese version's more of a slow burn, while the American edit, Godzilla 1985, is tighter and brings back Raymond Burr's character from the original's US version. If you like a more serious approach, this one might be for you. Godzilla vs. Biollante has an interesting plot involving industrial espionage and genetic engineering, plus one of Godzilla's most memorable opponents. Highly recommended. Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah takes a hard left turn into more outlandish sci-fi territory with a time travel plot, superhuman androids, laser guns, and other elements. Its weak human cast makes it difficult to recommend to a newcomer to the series, but if those aspects of it appeal to you, go ahead and give it a go. Godzilla vs. Mothra improves on the human element from the last film, but not much else. It repeats some of the social and ecological themes of the original Mothra vs. Godzilla, but in a much more banal and childish manner. I wouldn't recommend starting here. Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla 2 is one of the weakest and least engaging entries in the entire series. There's a certain stiffness to the 90s films that's perhaps at its worst here. Recurring supporting character Miki Saigusa finally gets some character development here, but it's not enough to make the movie worth recommending. Godzilla vs. Space Godzilla has some of the same issues as other 90s entries, but the human element is improved by a different writer and director duo, and Takayuki Hattori's music does plenty to liven things up compared with original series composer Akira Ifukube's somewhat rote scores during this period. Still, maybe not the best place to start. Godzilla vs. Destoroyah is back to business as usual, and would probably be worse than Mechagodzilla 2 if not for the climactic meltdown sequence. Again, not a good place to start. Conventional wisdom on the 1998 Godzilla holds that it's a bad film that gets everything about Godzilla wrong. It's certainly not a great representation of the character, but I personally find it so big and dumb and full of 90s blockbuster hubris that it's kind of endearing. It's a lot of people's first and only exposure to Godzilla, but if you haven't already seen it, I wouldn't start here. That said, taken with a grain of salt, it's not awful. Don't write it off until you have seen it. Godzilla 2000 is an excellent introduction, being a reboot with a solid and likable human cast that focuses on Godzilla while still delivering a climactic battle with another monster. It's also almost universally agreed to be better in its dubbed, slightly trimmed US version, which adds a bit more levity than was present in the original cut. Godzilla vs. Megaguirus isn't the series' worst, but it is pretty dull and mostly feels like a lesser first draft of the much better Godzilla against Mechagodzilla. Godzilla, Mothra, and King Ghidorah, Giant Monsters All Out Attack is a pretty solid introduction that features some A-list monsters and expands upon the themes in the original regarding World War II. Godzilla against Mechagodzilla is my personal favorite film in the series, with an incredibly strong cast of characters, an excellent Mechagodzilla design, a great score, and seriously, I love the characters in this one. The plot somewhat resembles Neon Genesis Evangelion, particularly Episode 6, and in general it feels kinda like a live-action anime, so if you like mecha shows, this might be your ideal starting point. Godzilla Tokyo SOS is a direct sequel to the previous film, and while its human cast is a step down, the music is still magnificent and the special effects are incredible, with Mothra looking better than she has since 1961. I wouldn't necessarily start here, but by all means start with the previous film and then watch this one. Godzilla Final Wars is a bit controversial. The director gets a bit bogged down making the martial arts action movie he really wants to make, but there's still the biggest monster cast since Destroy All Monsters and plenty of action. If you don't mind lowering your expectations in pretty much every other category,
go right into it!
The 2014 film is a no-brainer. This is another one you might have already seen, but go ahead and rewatch it. It's not the series' best, but the new film is a direct sequel to this one. Shin Godzilla definitely is one of the series' best. Hideaki Anno, the creator and director of Evangelion, knocks this one out of the park. I'd say check it out if you're an Eva fan, but you probably already have. Regardless, this one isn't a bad place to start. Finally, we come to the anime trilogy, which I've just picked apart in detail over on Blue Nova's channel. If you're an anime fan, particularly a fan of Gen Urobuchi's other work, then don't let me stop you from checking these out, but at least check out one or two of the other films as well. Of course, with these recommendations in mind, we come to the issue of how to watch these movies. Most of the newer ones are readily available on home video, but a lot of the classics are currently out of print and carry high asking prices for secondhand copies. Criterion is rumored to be working on a box set of most or all of the Showa series, covering the original film up through Terror of Mechagodzilla, but if that is coming, it's a ways off. Many of these films are, however, available on their streaming service, among others, but really, it's 2019. Regardless of the status of official releases, there are ways of finding and watching these movies.
No matter what happens, Godzilla will live.
Thanks a lot for watching. I've been pretty busy lately, so there really hasn't been much progress at all on the Godzilla against Mechagodzilla video, but I will try to kind of buckle down and get that one done quickly after King of the Monsters comes out. I appreciate your patience while I kind of put off the one I've been hyping a little bit in favor of these more spontaneous, smaller videos. I also have to give a quick shout out to my first Patreon backer, Exploder Button, who has asked that I do a video on Godzilla Raids Again at some point, so that'll be coming up as well. Before or after the Against Mechagodzilla video, I don't really know. In any case, hope you guys enjoyed the video, hope you found these suggestions helpful if you're new to the series, and I can't wait to tell you guys about King of the Monsters when it comes out. So stay tuned, thanks a lot for watching, I'll catch you guys next time.